I am the Trenchcoat Anti-Critic, and with me today is Jeffery Gerein. Say hello to the audience.
Hello, audience.
Excellent. And now what we are going to do is get shit-faced.
Right, to the house.
That's pretty rancid, man.
It's not particularly good, is it?
Mr. Grime.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you have been working for... You've been working for a while on this idea for a movie. It's called Time We Lost. Have they found it yet?
It took a while, but we dusted it off and brought it into production. I couldn't even believe it. It was really fantastic. I lost out to the film being made in film school. However, after the fact, when people, you know, woke up out of the stupor, they decided, hey, perhaps we can make this.
Because after all, film school is just one long drinking game, right?
Well, that goes without saying. Before bar fights. Moving right along. So, we went into production after our off-the-grid had been, you know, officially approved.
Off-the-grid. Can you tell me exactly what off-the-grid actually stands for?
Off-the-grid means we are stepping away from the grid. The point of it is to make a film outside of film school while in film school.
But you're not in film school right now, are you?
That's correct.
So how does that work?
In association with film school. We're all unlucky filmmakers at heart.
Indeed.
That's the best way of putting it, I would say. Everyone wants money. Do you have experience? No. Well, do you want experience? Yes, but you have to get experience. But I don't have any. Well, go get some, and then come back.
Yes.
You see our problem.
It's a catch-22.
Quite.
I want a job!
No.
Okay.
Carry on.
So, basically, Time We Lost is a buddy cop drama about cats.
Well, there's no cops, but a cop did stop by on the set to wish us well.
Ah, how'd that go?
It was, we had to all change our pants. We thought we were in quite a serious amount of trouble. But, we explained to him the situation, then he approached us after, and he just said, "Psh, we're just making a film." Then I said, "How was your night going?" He said, "Well, obviously for stopping you, it mustn't be that busy, but..." So, and he drove away, and the rest of the night went particularly smooth.
Nice. Kind of like this beer is totally not going down at this point.
Mm-mm.
That's what I call an off-the-grid beer.
Mm-mm. You, sir, are a master of words.
Yes, comic timing is my forte. What's the story of this monstrosity?
Oh, monstrosity is putting it lightly. We have a main character by the name of James, who is in debt to some very dangerous people.
Aren't we all?
Ignorance is bliss.
Yes.
And what he does to escape the scenario and his crumbling marriage and his daughter, who has no idea what's going on, is to reach out to his closest friend. They meet at a bar, actually, and to get his point across, he's trying to tell Ethan that, you know, he's out of money, his marriage is crumbling, everything that he believes in is slowly falling apart. So, he reaches out to a person, and unfortunately, it turns out to be, in many ways, the wrong person. The cuts of this are gonna make this significantly better.
So you're saving it in post, then?
Oh, yes. But overall, it was a very enjoyable experience. We had plenty of beer, and we had plenty of fun at 4 a.m. on a Friday evening in Hollywood.
In Hollywood?
No, we didn't actually go there. Illuminati spies.
The Illuminati spies, they will destroy us all, provided...
Provided?
Provided that you have some kind of a film that's low budget and doesn't have anything, and they'll just come in and go, "You can't do that."
Yes, I have every intention of screwing every producer that I'm involved with, except for the one that I'm working with right now. The ending of this particular piece is very ambiguous. We're trying to maintain a mystery of sorts, and even if I were to tell you, you still wouldn't know.
Yes! You're going for David Lynch, aren't you?
Ever so subtly.
Any midgets speaking backwards?
We were thinking about it, but they're hard to get out here.
Hmm. God bless the little people. Now, you had the privilege of working with some very talented individual. Can you talk about the actors that you had involved with this?
My goodness. I've never had a greater time on set, really, with the various actors that we had. We had Jason Cermak and Gray Laschuk and Allison. She doesn't have a last name. It's just Allison, like Prince. Really? I had the incredible great privilege of working with some fantastic crew members who stuck by me through thick and thin, rain and sleet. Not so much sleet, but more rain. And
lots of rain.
Lots of rain.
That's the unfortunate thing about working in Vancouver!
Yeah, it's like Seattle, only with more rain.
And now, let's cut to
a preview.
Hey, Jimmy, thought you still wanted to grab a drink later. It's been a while, after all. I'll now have to clear an Amy.
I'm not doing okay. It's been really hard lately.
It'll be okay.
James, you know why I'm calling.
Claire knows. I tried so hard to keep her from finding out. Let's go for a drive. It'll take your mind off it. How long have you been doing this?
A long time.
You dropped your glasses.
Well, you ever wonder if what you're fighting for is worth all this?